everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a second order differential equations problem, but we're going to be given initial values in this problem, so it's going to be a combination of second order differential equations and initial values. The equation that we're given is 2y double prime minus 11y prime plus 12y equals 0, and we've been given the initial conditions y of 0 equals 5 and y prime of 0 equals 15. So keep in mind that y double prime here represents the second derivative of the original equation y, and y prime represents the first derivative of the original equation y. The formula that we're going to be using for this problem, as with all second order differential equations problem, is this formula here for y of x. So just to give you kind of a preview of what we're going to be doing, we are going to be solving first for r sub 1 and r sub 2 here in the exponents. Once we do that, we're going to come up with an equation for y of x that still has c sub 1 and c sub 2 in it. We will take the derivative of y of x to get y prime of x, and then we'll use our initial conditions for y of 0 and y prime of 0 to plug in those values, solve for c sub 1 and c sub 2, and once we found those values, we'll plug them in and we'll come up with a final formula for y of x, and that'll be our final answer. So, like I said, the first thing we're going to do is solve for r sub 1 and r sub 2, and the way that we do that is we convert our original equation here to an equation with r's in it instead of y's. And the way that we do that, simply, if we have y here, we treat it as 1. If we have y prime, we treat it as r, and if we have y double prime, we treat it as r squared. The easiest thing for me to remember is to just count the hash marks on the y's. If you have 0 hash marks here, right, we have y with 0 hash marks, that's r to the 0, which is 1. Anything raised to the 0 power is 1, so we would multiply 12 by 12 times 1, and we would just get 12. Here, y prime, we have 1 hash mark, that means it's r to the 1, which is just r, and we plug in r. We've got 2 hash marks here for y double prime, that's r squared, and we end up here with r squared. So it's a stupid trick, it's not mathematical, but it makes it easy for me to remember what is 1, what's r, and what's r squared when I plug those into the equation here. So once I do that, like I said, we're going to solve for r, and in this case we can factor our equation to 2r minus 3 times r minus 4. If you can't factor, you can try completing the square or using the quadratic formula, but either way you want to solve for r, and obviously we're going to end up with two factors here. So what we do is we set each of these factors equal to 0. So we'll start with 2r minus 3 equals 0. We add 3 to both sides and we get 2r equals 3. And then we divide both sides by 2 and we get r equals 3 halves. Now we're going to do the same thing with r minus 4 equals 0. We're taking this factor here, setting it equal to 0. Obviously we just add 4 to both sides and we get r equals 4. So those are our two solutions for r. As you can see here, 3 halves and 4. And what we're going to do is plug those into our formula for r sub 1 and r sub 2. It doesn't particularly matter which order you do. I usually take the smaller factor and plug it in for r sub 1. So I have r sub 1 equal to 3 halves and r sub 2 equal to 4. So this is our equation here for y of x. Now what we're going to want to do is take the derivative of y of x. And the way that we do that, we treat c1 and c2 as a coefficient on this e to the x term. So they're going to stay right where they are as coefficients. Remember that the derivative of e to some constant times x, right, this 3 halves is the constant, it's the coefficient on the x term right here. Taking the derivative of that kind of a term, it means that we just multiply this 3 halves out in front of the term, leaving the exponent 3 halves x completely intact. So all we do is bring this 3 halves out in front, the c sub 1 stays right where it is, and the exponent remains unchanged, Same thing here with the second term. We bring the 4 out in front, and the c sub 2 stays right where it is, as does the exponent 4x. So that is the derivative of y of x, so it's y prime of x. Now we're going to need both of these equations. We're going to use our initial conditions here, and for this first initial condition, y of 0 equals 5, we will plug in 0 to our equation for y of x, we'll plug it in 4x to y of x, and we'll set it equal to 5. And then for our second initial condition, y prime of 0 equals 15, we will plug 0 in for x to y prime, the derivative, and set that equal to 15. We'll come out with two equations that both include c sub 1 and c sub 2, and then we'll use simultaneous equations to solve for c sub 1 and c sub 2. So let's bring these two equations in here. These are the ones that we had just found, y of x and y prime of x. And now let's start working with our initial conditions. So you can see here we're working with y of x, the original y of x equation that we found here. And we're going to plug in 0 for x. So you can see we have y of 0. We're plugging in 0 for x, and we're setting it equal to 5, as our initial condition indicates that we should do. So we just plug in 0, we set it equal to 5. Remember that anything raised to the 0 power is 1, which means that we'll end up with c sub 1 times 1 plus c sub 2 times 1 is equal to 5. Obviously, when we simplify that, we get c sub 1 plus c sub 2 equals 5. So that's our first equation. We'll keep that in the back of our mind. We'll move on to the second initial condition, and then we'll bring this back later to solve for c sub 1 and c sub 2 using simultaneous equations. So now, taking our second initial condition, we will plug in 0 for x to y prime and set that equal to 15. So you can see y prime of 0, we're plugging in 0 for x here and here and setting it equal to 15, just as we did with y of 0 equals 5. So again, anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So this e to the 3 halves times 0 just becomes 1, and we're left with 3 halves c sub 1 times 1, and then again plus 4 times c sub 2 times 1. Obviously, when we simplify, these 1s go away, and we're left with 3 halves c sub 1 plus 4 c sub 2 equals 15. So these two here, c sub 1 plus c sub 2 equals 5, and this one we just found, are the simultaneous equations that we'll use to solve for c sub 1 and c sub 2. Let's go ahead and work with our second equation. I'm going to multiply all of the terms by 2 to get just so that I can get rid of the fraction. I'm going to end up with 3 times c sub 1. This will become 8 c sub 2, and then 2 times 15 will be 30. And then we'll bring back our first equation that we got from y of 0 equals 5, c sub 1 plus c sub 2 equals 5. We'll subtract c sub 2 from both sides to solve for c sub 1, and then plug in this 5 minus c sub 2 into our other equation here for c sub 1. You can see we took this part here and plugged it in for this c sub 1 so that we can have just c sub 2 in this equation and solve for it like a variable. So distributing the 3 here, 3 times 5 gives us 15 minus 3 times c sub 2 here. Obviously the rest of the equation stays the same. And then when we simplify this, negative 3 c sub 2 plus 8 c sub 2 is a positive 5 c sub 2. And when we subtract 15 from both sides, we get that 5 c sub 2 is equal to 15. Dividing both sides by 5 gives us c sub 2 equal to 3. So now that we've solved for c sub 2, we can plug it back in to our first equation here. We're going to plug in for c sub 2, and we'll get c sub 1 plus 3 equals 5. When we subtract 3 from both sides, we'll get c sub 1 equals 2. So that's how you solve for both of those variables. And remember from before, we had our equation already with r sub 1 and r sub 2 filled in. Well, now we're going to take that same one and plug in c sub 1 and 2 to get our final answer. So we had plugged in 3 halves for r sub 1 we found C sub 1 to be 2, so we plug it in here. We plug in 3 for C sub 2, and 4 was what we came up with for R sub 2, and so that carried over into our final answer here. So this is the equation y of x that ends up being our final answer, where we've solved for both C sub 1 and 2 and R sub 1 and 2. I hope that example helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!